right, everybody. Now, let's go to the next draw. This is actually a very interesting draw because we've got two players that actually played yesterday in a final playing in this event in France. The Open 13, or the... where is it played? Is it in Marseille? Marseille, right? Medvedev's the defending champ. He is not playing. He is not playing this event. And a few other names are pulled out of this event as well. We have Berrinkas. He's pulled out of this one. Also, Humbert pulled out of this one. Maga is also out. And Yannick Sinner, he is also pulled out of this event. Sinner's having a couple of issues with off-court stuff. Big names are playing. Let's go have a look at the top of the draw. Stefanos Tsitsipas. He is the number one seed. Top four seeds get a bye in the first round. And Steph, coming off the loss yesterday, is going straight to France to play again. I think he won this tournament. Did he win this tournament a few times in a row? Let me triple check. I think he won it twice in a row, didn't he? Until last year where he lost it to Medi. But Tsitsipas is like a two-time champion here. Yeah, 2019, 2020. He won this back-to-back. So he doesn't mind playing at this event. Maybe an early prediction. He gets a bye in the first round anyway. He'll be playing the winner of Gaston versus Moutet, who are going at it in the first round, two Frenchmen. So no matter what happens, Tsitsipas is going to play in front of a tough crowd in the second round. Then we've got two qualies going at it. Winner of that qualifier battle will take on either another qualifier or the number seven seed Popperin, who I've been very bullish on over the last 12 months as one of the best Australian players going around. Second part of the draw, and look at that. FAA back in action again. No break for FAA. He gets the third seed. He will be getting a bye in the first round. Winner of that, he'll be playing a Frenchman in the second round because we've got Tsonga versus Simon, which 10 years ago was a final because those guys were in the top 10. Now they're wild cards. So the second, and they're very, very loved in France too. So Tsitsipas and FAA both have very tough second rounds against Frenchmen. Not fun, especially after a good week last week. Both those guys are going to have to battle. Then we've got Trevallier versus Laxinen. Winner of that match takes on either Gombas or number five seed Vashka in the second round. I think FAA is going to have a bit of a tough week this week. I think after winning his first title, he's worked his ass off to get it. I just don't know if FAA is going to be able to back it up this week. To be honest, if he loses to Tsonga or Simon, I don't think anyone will be upset with that. I think we'll all understand if he has a letdown this week. But man, that's a tough one for FAA. Playing against a beloved, if he plays Tsonga, the crowd are gonna go wild and FAA is gonna have to battle his ass off to win. But interesting part of the draw, we'll see. FAA should get through, but I don't know. All right, then we go to the bottom half of the draw. We've got the number nine seed, Bonzi versus Majerzak in the first round. Winner of that match takes on either a qualifier or Herbert in the second round. Then we've got another qualifier taking on Rune. Winner of that match takes on the number four seed, Karatsev, in the second round. Karatsev getting a bye in the first round. He hasn't been seeded, or at least hasn't been highly seeded at many events. And the ones he has been, I think it was a top seed, what, 2 weeks ago or last week? He lost pretty early. So Karatsev is in a little bit of trouble. He's having a bit of a backward slide. And he needs to regain some form. And maybe this is where he can do it on the indoor hard courts. But there's a lot of Frenchmen in this part of the draw. If he can avoid the Frenchmen, maybe he can avoid that annoying, you know, crazy crowd. But we'll see. Karatsev, you know, not a bad draw. Not a bad draw. Then the bottom section of the draw, we've got Grixpor, the number six seed, taking on Puy, who's a wild card of this one. Winner of that takes on either Elbot or Dennis Novak in the second round. Then we've got Gasquet taking on Ima. Winner of that match takes on the number two seed, Rublev, in the second round. Very good draw for Rublev, but unfortunately for Rublev, sometimes the best draws are the worst draws because he does lose some weird matches. If he plays Gasquet and the crowd start getting involved, Rublev might lose to Gasquet. So I think Rublev's hoping that he avoids against the Frenchman because I think Rublev is going to get in his own head if the crowd are getting crazy. We'll see what happens. But I mean, Rublev and Karatsev, out of the top four seeds, they've got the best draw. I feel like Tsitsipas and FAA have a tougher draw than these two guys. So maybe one of those two guys gets through and wins the whole thing. Let me know in the chat. I think that Rublev might be able to get through. I think, look, Karatsev's a good bet too. I think the bottom half of the draw is where the winner's going to come from. I think the top half with Tsitsipas and FAA having to play Frenchman, I think that's going to be a problem. But let me know in the chat. Let me know in the comments below. Who do you think is going to win this event? Tsitsipas has won this before. Maybe that can be something that you hang your hat on. People are going to be bullish on FAA to win again. Go back to back. I'm leaning Rublev. I think he's got the best draw if you can avoid that second round opponent in Gasquet. But you let me know. What do you reckon? We've got Tsitsipas. We've got a few people saying Rublev. A couple of saying FAA.